Following the IED blast on March 9th, the Meghalaya police arrested senior HNYF member Thirson Limba, a 55-year-old from Shnopadeng in West Jaintia Hills, and is now being produced before the district court. To get insights about the arrest, East Mojo correspondent interacted with HNYF President Sadon Bla.
Babla, if you can tell us, this 55-year-old Limba, he's how active was he of in the organization HNYF?
He's in association with HNYF in the past 24-25 years. And he is very active, and he's senior most in the organization by age, by activity, or by whatever that we are in the organization respecting us as he is, because he's senior most. I would say that in his leadership, the organization has never gone astray. The HNYF has never gone astray. HNYF and organization, we have not made any trouble as such, because we have people like him who guide the youth of the organization. So with this accusation now that he is involved in the bomb blast, the entire body of HNYF, we are not digesting this accusation against Professor Limba that he is involved in the bomb blast. Mm-hmm.
So you have met the SP earlier today. What is the SP saying? Based on what reasons that they are they're alleging that he is part of the blast?
The SP is showing his police procedure that when I inquire, I have told him straight that I'm not, the organization, we are the organization, we are not believing that Thirson is in any way involved in this bomb blast. But the SP said that they have clue that he is involved. So all we can say is to the police department is all of us, let them find out the clue if they can establish.
Okay.
Because we don't believe that Thirson Limba will be involved in this.
Babla, you've also mentioned that the police in the past have tend to victimize the NGOs. Can you tell us more about that?
If you look in the past years, that shootout in Nong Silia, if you could remember, recollect, where the three HNSC cadres were slain. At that point of time, they victimized the KSU, accusing that the KSU is directly involved with the anti-national organization like the HNSC. Then, now, whenever this bomb blast happened, now they are victimized other NGOs, and recently they are victimizing the HNF. Just because the HNF has been a patch breaker, has been in the leading front to bring the HLC to the peace talk. They are trying to conclude otherwise that we are having connection with the HLC. Connection with the HLC, they are human beings, we are human beings. We come here for peace talk, we sit, we chit chat together, we talk, we eat, drink together. But if you say that is a connection, then so be it, that is a connection. But apart from that connection that we have as human beings, as friends, as human beings, we don't have any other connection. But this kind of establishment that the police try to establish, the fact that the HNF is somehow involved in the HNF leaders, members are somehow involved in the activities of the HLC, the police department need to do some more homework, some more fact-finding on this matter.
Now, we see that this blast has occurred at Harijan Colony, which is an issue that has been going on for so many years. Till now, relocation has not taken place. Everyone is waiting. And though the government is saying that they're almost near, they're saying the blueprint is ready and all, do you think this has become an issue for the public, or like you mentioned that it is an eyesore for the public?
Like you see, right now, if you go anywhere, start interviewing the youth that walk along the street or PBU Yodo or Light Mkhra, anywhere. Ask them about Chemotor, you'll see how provoked they are. Why? Because the government, since that Chemotor incident that happened, that curfew, that stone thing and all, since that incident happened, the government, instead of relocate those illegal settlers out there, the government is giving them protection. Protection to the point that common people cannot use that road also, because government is overprotecting them. So, Bumblas in Maulong Hat has to be looked from a different perspective also, because it is an eyesore to all the common people, to all the common youth, to all the people who are allergic to the existence of those illegal settlers out there. So they cannot simply pinpoint this NGO members, that NGO members, or this leader, that leader, or this organization, or that organization. Because when the Thermotor incident episode did take place, none of the organization are involved there. Mm. It is the public, it is the mass. It is the public and the masses that are involved in creating all those necessities to remove those illegal settlers from there. So how come now a particular organization take credit or take responsibility to remove them all when the movement was a mass movement? Was a movement of the public.
Okay. Now we see that the SP in a statement yesterday has informed that the bomb blast is very similar to those which has been claimed by HNLC in the past, the kind of gelatin sticks and the way it was planned and all. They're saying that it's similar to HNLC. Do you?
No, see, that's a funny statement. A bomb is a bomb. A bomb is a bomb. I mean, normally IED are made of gelatin sticks. Anyway, a bomb is a bomb, so if I make a bomb, I make a bomb. If HNLC make a bomb, if anybody make a bomb is a bomb. I mean, similarity, the equipment are used are the same. So similarity are bound to arise. They cannot come to that premature conclusion like it is the anti-war of the same organization or so on.
Okay. So, right now you haven't heard, since you are the interlocutor of HNLC, has there been any updates from their end? What is also about the peace talks? What is going to happen now?
Now you see, now there is a kind of interval in this peace process. Interval, I would say, in the peace process because of the misunderstanding between the government of India, government of Meghalaya, and HNLC. But it does not mean the total closure of the topic concerned. Okay. It's not. Now recently, I have seen in the media that when the media inquire Chief Minister about why this peace talk was derailed. And the statement that the Chief Minister said that HNLC has to abide by the norms of the central government. Myself, being the interlocutor, I have not seen a single point norm in writing. They have not circulated any single norm in writing. So, what norm do we have to follow? What are the points, the parameters of it? We don't know. That exists in the air. So, if that norm is applicable, I mean, if that norm is in existence in writing, then we can talk about this norm. We don't see any norm.
Okay. Thank you so much, Mark. Okay. Well, that was the president of HNYF, and I'm right in front of the SP office where the members of HNYF have just met the SP of East Khasi Hills and to understand why exactly have they arrested a member, a very senior member, who's 55 year old from HNYF. He is from Shnong Penang, which is a distance away from Shillong. And he was brought to Shillong yesterday itself, and today we had witnessed he was taken for medical checkup. Right now, as we're reporting, he is being produced before the district court. We will bring you further updates on relating to this IED blast that occurred on March 9th at Harijan Colony here in Shillong. This is Princess Rasha reporting for EastMojo.com.
Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to East Mojo. For any queries, put them down in the comments section below and press on the bell icon for notifications.